Hi, and welcome to this video. My name is Brian Mertens. I'm from www.naturementor.com. And today, I'm going to be talking about bird language. If you're familiar with the five voices of the birds, and you spent some time outside in the field listening for companion calls and songs and alarms, you might have noticed that a lot of times there's significant overlap between what a companion call is and what an alarm is. A lot of times it isn't clear, and birds might be actually using the same sound, the same vocalization, in a different context, which is sometimes companion call and sometimes alarm. So the subject of this video is looking at, when you hear that, you know, what else can you pay attention to? When you're not sure about the actual reason a bird is making a particular call, how can you figure out what it's actually making that noise for? So the first thing to pay attention to is the number of birds that are involved in the behavior. If you're hearing a bird making a call and you're not sure if it's a companion call or if it's an alarm, listen for how many other birds are joining in on it. If you're in a place where there's a lot of different species, and it's just one species that's making a particular call, it's less likely that it's going to be an alarm, because alarms tend to be multi-species response. They draw in, when a robin hears a sparrow alarming, if they're in the same area, the robin will go in there and will alarm as well. You have to take into account the general activity, but a good rule to go by is that the more birds that are alarming together, the more likely it's actually an alarm. The second thing to look at is the length of time that this behavior goes on for. Even if it's just one species that's doing it, if that bird is making that call, and it's going and it's going and it's going, and it's been like 10 minutes, 15 minutes, that might be something that you still want to investigate, even though it's just one bird. On the other hand, if you hear a bird calling, and it only happens for, you know, maybe 15 or 20 seconds, it's a lot less likely that there's a predator there, and you're not really even going to be able to investigate that one, because it starts and then it's just done. There's nothing else happening. It can happen where, you know, you'll hear an alarm for a little while, and then it'll stop, and you'll think, okay, it's done. Maybe it wasn't an alarm, but then if you keep listening, maybe 2 or 3 minutes later in kind of a different spot but close by, you might start to hear the alarms pick up again. And if you keep listening over a length of time, you might start to hear that it's moving across the landscape in a slow way. And so that's something that tells you that there's something you might want to investigate there, if you're hearing that. So yeah, always investigate that kind of stuff. Another thing to look at is this a repeating pattern? You know, if you're out on the same landscape day after day and you're observing bird language, are the calls that you're having questions about, like, is this an alarm, is it a call, is it happening in the same place? You know, is there a particular wood pile that always seems to have this kind of stuff going on around it? That could be telling you something. And that doesn't mean that it is an alarm, but it's a really good opportunity to learn. Another way that this happens is, like with cats, if they're using the same trail over and over again, you'll start to hear the same alarms in the same places over and over again. And so if you can figure out that kind of pattern and know that that's taking place, you can bring that knowledge to your interpretations of the bird language in the moment, and that's going to give you a lot more certainty about whether something's actually going on, because you'll know that, hey, this is a pattern that happens over and over again, I'm seeing it again, or wow, that's in a spot that I've never seen that before, maybe I need to check it out. And so that's something you can do. So thanks for watching. I think if you put these questions into practice while you're out there listening, it'll help you kind of get a handle on what's actually an alarm and what's actually a call, just to kind of get some certainty around that. Because that's going to make a difference for your interpretations of the bird language. So I hope you like this video. If you have any comments, I'd love to hear from you. You can just put them in the box below. And if you're watching this on YouTube, you can subscribe to my channel. I do plan on making more videos as time goes on, so I'd love to keep you informed.